Hello, my name is Rajesh Francis, and I'm a Senior Analytics Customer Experience Specialist at AWS. Amazon Redshift Serverless is a serverless option of Amazon Redshift with all existing functionality and offers a simple user experience. It scales dynamically based on incoming workloads, and you pay only for the compute capacity you use. In this demo, I will demonstrate how Amazon Redshift Serverless intelligently scales based on incoming workloads for best performance and show you how you can estimate cost for the capacity you use. I have run some sample workloads simulating heavy usage with hundreds of users and thousands of queries. This chart is based on the actual workload and shows how Amazon Redshift Serverless compute capacity has scaled based on incoming queries. Let's spend a minute to understand this using a QuickSight dashboard. This shows relationship between query count in blue, execution time in green, and the RPU, which is the Redshift Processing Unit, in orange colors. The RPU starts off at 0 and starts to scale automatically to default RPU of 128, then to 768 as more queries come in, and all the way to 1408 to process the peak workload, which is over 20,000 queries. Again, as you can see, query count in blue shows 20,410, and RPU in orange shows 1408. And then the RPU goes back down to 0 when there are no queries. But as you can see, even with the peak workload of queries, the query execution time, shown in green color, remains consistent. This shows Redshift Serverless is able to scale to process incoming queries as they come in to deliver consistent, fast performance, even for the most demanding workloads. And then the RPU goes back down to 0 when there are no workloads, and you pay only for the RPU seconds used. Now let us see how cost is calculated based on usage. With Amazon Redshift Serverless, you pay for compute and storage separately. You pay for the workloads you run in RPU hours on a per second basis with a 60-second minimum charge, and you will not be charged for idle time, which is when no queries or workloads is running. Comprehensive security capabilities are included, and you do not pay separately for concurrency scaling or to query data in S3 using Redshift Spectrum, because it is part of the RPU calculation and the RPU itself could scale up or down based on workloads. As we just saw earlier in the dashboard, Amazon Redshift Serverless automatically provisions and scales resources up or down based on workload variability to meet unpredictable demands. So you don't have to worry about over-provisioning or under-provisioning resources. For storage, you are charged a fixed gigabyte per month based on S3 pricing. The data you ingest into Redshift Serverless is persisted in Redshift Managed Storage, which is a combination of local SSD and S3, and is available even when RPU goes down to 0. Amazon Redshift Serverless can give you the best price for performance for various types of workloads: variable, unpredictable workloads, periodic workloads with idle time, and steady-state workloads where there is consistent usage for a period of time. Our recommendation is to execute a representative workload for your peak and non-peak time periods and calculate the average compute usage. And that average can be used as the base RPU for serverless. You can also monitor both RPU capacity and compute usage from the monitoring section of Amazon Redshift Serverless console. Here you see the RPU capacity scale from 0 to 128 for normal workload and to 400 for heavy workload and back to 0 when there is really no workload. And similarly, you have the compute usage in seconds in this dashboard as well. This metric is also available in CloudWatch under AWS Redshift Serverless, and you can look at metrics with node dimensions and review compute capacity and compute seconds. You can also change the base RPU capacity to scale beyond 128 under the Limits tab in the Serverless configuration, and Serverless will automatically scale to that default RPU. Compute seconds is the accumulated compute unit consumed, and it is calculated by multiplying compute capacity times the number of seconds the compute is used. This value is stored in Sys serverless usage table in 30-minute intervals. Now, if we take this line item as an example for 2022-2004, between 2105 and 2135, total compute seconds is 1133. Then to calculate the total cost for this period, you can convert the seconds, which is 133 to hours, 1133 to hours, which will be 0.315. And cost of compute in US East 1 region is 50 cents per hour. So the cost of compute for the time period is 15 cents for 0.315 hours. You can use the SQL statements below to calculate the total compute cost and the total storage cost based on data in the Sys serverless usage table. And this aggregates the cost by day. In this demo, I showed you how Amazon Redshift Serverless scales based on the demands of your workload to provide consistent performance and how you can calculate costs for compute and storage you actually use. We encourage you to try Amazon Redshift Serverless, and you can get more details using this link. Thank you.